Right. I can stand firm and I can tell anybody anywhere that Jesus is my answer. Yeah. I'll follow him because he is the all and finish of my life. He knows what lies ahead. And I don't have to worry about tomorrow. I just have to trust and believe that Jesus will lead me in the right direction. Right. See, I don't care where it's down in the courthouse or whether it's the White House. Jesus still is the head of my life. He's the answer for anything I have. And he is the reason that I continue to get up every morning, trusting and believing that he would never leave me. He would never forsake me. I have decided to follow Jesus no matter where he leads me. Whether it's down in the valley or up on the mountaintop, where he leads me, I will follow. Amen. And these brothers left their father. And followed him.
Well,
they didn't know him. They didn't know what he could do for him. Because see, we have been saying, fishes are men, why want to catch men? But as we read the story, we understand. And he told them, he sent them out without script. Told them, where are you go? If they receive you, let your blessing go into the house. If they don't, then leave there and shake the dust off your feet. We want to honor with people. We ain't got to argue with them. They don't want to receive us. We just leave. Take our peace with us and go on somewhere. Stop wasting our time arguing with somebody that don't believe anyway. They're not, I don't want to believe anyway. You're going to sit there arguing with me. Because two people argue who can tell who the fool and who for real and who's not. But listen, God bless you and move on. Because where you won't listen, God has sent someone else to listen. You may not accept me, but you're going to have to accept God if you plan on living a prosperous life. You know, we have cars. We buy these business cars. Not when they sit in a box in the church, but for us to take them. And we don't know what to say. Just meet me right here on Sunday morning. Or just what, meet me on Wednesday night.
Yeah.
All right, you get a little week along the way, get a car there, just call somebody. Hold up, I'll put my number on there. Just call me sometime. There's a lot we can do, not a simple thing. You may not know how to talk to somebody, but everybody has somebody they can talk to. And everybody ought to have someone that need them to talk to. We got people that are sick. We got people that are shut in. There are people that are going through. There is somebody we need to encourage in the name of Jesus Christ. We hear enough word in this place today. We ought to be able to write books on it. We ought to be able to write all across the wall how good Jesus is and how wonderful he is.
All right.
We ought to have enough respect for the world and everybody in it because of the word we have been heard. We ought to have love. We don't have to think, should I love her? We ought to just know, I love her. I forgive her. I love her. She don't know what she said. We ain't got to put nobody down. We ain't got to curse nobody out. We ain't got to do all that stuff. We just bless them. God bless you, honey. There are some people you just have to walk away from. But they trash your spirit.
Amen.
But God give us, but if we are following him, God give us that blessed hope that he is in Christ Jesus. So none of us should be sitting back there waiting what's next.
My Lord.
We ought to be up doing what we need to do until the next call comes. Right. For God to tell us, look, you go on that way. Now I need you to follow me over here. Because there is a direction we should be going. None of us should be heading down a dead end road. Not if we are following God. None of us should be heading down a road that doesn't lead to helping somebody. Not if we are following God. Like I said, it don't even take a whole lot. It might not even take but a lunch to help somebody. Might not take but a dollar. We look at it as I got to give something big. No, we don't. Giving is giving. Even if you do what the church has told you to do, that is gift. You need to bring your tithes on to the storehouse. Pay your vows. Pay your assessment. All of that is being in the will of God. And giving is giving. You don't know who to give to? Give to the church. Put it in a banana offering. And the church will know. Because people come to the church all the time looking for him. You don't have to worry about where is she going to do it. It doesn't matter. Because once you've done what God has told you to do, it doesn't matter what they do or how they do it. We trust God. We're not trusting in him. If you're doing it for just to get glorification, just to be seen a man, then maybe you should worry. But if you're doing it in the will of God, once you dispel your duty, you should have a clear conscience and a sound mind. Amen. You should be able and rejoice in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, God, I'm ready to follow you to the next one. I'm ready to follow you to the next challenge. I'm ready to follow you to the next thing that's going to help me grow in you. See, following Christ don't mean that we just follow him and that's it. We have to follow him and think about all that he did. He was going, even this morning we heard how he was going to raise Jairus' daughter when the woman with the issue of blood touched his tongue. He was going somewhere. Each time he was helping somebody. And he just said, no, you ain't no problem, man. I can't help you right now. Wait on the cameras and all the people they're going to talk about. He did what he had to do. They didn't say what a good job he did. They said he was blaspheming in the name of God. They said he wasn't right. He was at a devil. And they're going to talk. But we have to keep on following Jesus Christ. And everybody not going to like us. Everybody not going to appreciate what we are doing. But our reward should be in heaven, not among men. So you looking for your reward among men, then you're going to get discouraged. You're going to be disappointed. You're going to want to turn around and turn back. Because we know the hearts of man. We know how it means, because we've been there. We've been at that point. But we haven't always, you know, I know we like to sit in here, you know, dress, all sit back like we done nothing in the world, that we were born blessed, we were born saved, we were born a Christian, we ain't never did nothing. I know that's the attitude we like to have. But we are living a lie. Because we all have done, you may not have done what I've done. But you've done something. And I thank God I have repented of what I've done. I thank God that because if I had it, I couldn't stand here and do what I'm doing. If I had repented to God and got my soul right with him, I'm following Christ Jesus. Though it might leave me alone sometimes. Though it may leave me where nobody want to be around me. I am happy in Jesus and Jesus alone. And he found me great. And once he, and the thing about it is following Jesus, you have to sit down and learn from somebody. So he taught his disciples. They was unlearned men, but he taught them. He taught them the will of God. He taught them the word. I'm like, the word is teaching them the word. And he told them to go out. And then when he was up on the mountain praying, I'm like, this, our God, our Jesus, was so in tune to God that even on the day that he knew he was going to be arrested, he was on the mount praying to God. You know, we get weak along the way. The flesh does get weak. We get tired. It gets sick. It gets disturbed. But through Christ Jesus, we ought to be able to do all things through Christ Jesus. And the flip side of that is without him, we can't do nothing. So there's a flip side of being in Christ Jesus. And if you're not in Christ Jesus, then don't get upset because things you want to do come to know. Because outside of him, we can't do nothing. And if we're not in him, then we need to figure out who we are in. Because there's only two. There's only one God. But there's a devil who wants to be a God. So if you're not in the will of God, then you better make sure you don't stay in the will of the devil. God sent before you good and evil. That's God and the devil. You choose God, then you follow him. But if you don't want God, then you're following the devil. So when things don't go right, don't be saying, Lord, help mercy, what happened? No. Say, Lord, help me. If I'm out of your will, God, help me to get that right. Help me to get back to following you. Because I don't want my ears like that. I want eternal life through Christ Jesus. So they left their father. And sometimes we have to leave situations. Sometimes we have to put down friends. You know, I'm not just talking about just be ugly and nasty to them. It's okay to speak. You know, let them see the light in you. So what it is, they need to be envy of it and want to know how can they do it. Now we want to be envy of somebody, not to the point that we hate them, but to the point where we want to know how they find this peace. How they find their joy. You know, you lost your job and you're going along singing, it'll be everything gonna be alright, gonna be alright. Come on, you going around all happy,